Alright guys, we've got something interesting for you in this one.
You guys know what these are, right?
Should, because if you don't, then you live under a rock.
Yeah, that's right. These are those solar-powered LED lawn lights that you can put along your driveway, garage, house, whatever, and they kind of illuminate the ground a little bit. These ones here, we bought at Walmart. We bought the whole box. They're about a buck. We bought 35 of them. It's 35 bucks. We have, what you don't see here, lines our fence line outside.
I've decided that since we have so many of these, I want to put some on our deck. But you can't really stick these things as they are along the deck. Alright? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build some L brackets with a little decorative loop to put these things on.
Alright, now occasionally you guys will probably see a bug fly around because it's about 1:30 in the morning and I'm out here in the garage doing this. What we have is a piece of 3-inch round pipe, okay? What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this pipe and I'm going to use that as my template to bend my 1/4-inch steel. This is what I'm going to make my decorative loop out of. And the decorative loop is not only going to be decorative, but it's also going to be structural. Bracket this pipe down to my table. So I'm going to take this piece of steel, flat stock, put that on there, weld, maybe just a simple tack will probably work too. So let's do that quick so I can clamp this down. Then I'm going to cut off a little chunk of this and then I'm going to weld it right onto the side here, and that's where I'm going to be taking my rods and sticking the rod in there and then bending it around, figuring out my spot, cutting it, then welding. All right. Just got those things all set up. Let me show you here quick. We have a tack here, tack there, and then we have bar right there. So, tubing, I should say. Now we need to clamp this down with a lot of force, man. With a lot of force! We need to have a lot of force for this thing to actually look so good, yes. But, well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now, what we're going to be doing here, I was thinking about making an S shape for this. But I decided not to, because since I'm only using this 3/16 is what this is.
Sorry, everybody, sometimes my brain just gets dumb. You know, I just keep operating in a dumb frame of mind. Through the whole video. It's like it happens on every video I do. If you guys, you know, I'll do a video that's like this damn long, and by the time I'm done editing it and cutting out all the dumb stuff I say, it's this long.
Took the flat stock, I cut it 10 inches long, made a mark at 5 inches, cut down through it about halfway, put clamps on it, grab the steel, and then just slowly bent it up. Like I said, you don't want to go fast because then it just breaks on you. Just bring it up nice and slowly, and I use my square here to give me that nice right angle. You'll notice that these are offset. I didn't put the ring in the very middle. The reason is because of the holes. I'll be able to put a screw right there and a screw right up over here, so that way I can get my tool in there to put them on the wall.
The plan was to make 7, but I ran out of angle iron, or not angle iron, but I ran out of the 1-inch piece here, and I only had a little chunk left over, and I can't do anything with that, so it looks like I'm only making 4 for right now. This piece right here came off of some old bed frame. One of those old bed frames that, you know, you get from Walmart? Well, that's what this came off of, and the wall thickness of this is like, I think it's like 0.065. It's really, really thin stuff. And you can see that when I was tacking it, it's really hard to weld that thin of steel onto this thick of steel. So what I had to do is I had to angle it down, weld the thick steel, so the pool would go down and then fuse with the thinner steel. So my arc, like right here, I tried not to hit this steel with my arc. But that didn't work right there. See the hole? Hole blew right through it. So, yeah, that's all these are. Got a little too hot, started blowing through them. But I guess it's kind of a good thing. That mistake is a good thing, because when I have a light inside here, if water ever pools up inside there somehow, I won't have to worry. You know, it'll drain out. and I won't have to worry about it sitting in there and crusting it all up and turning into a mass of rust down inside there. So, I've got four of these, and the light
is one of these things. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece of double-sided sticky tape, you know, the foam stuff, put a little bit of that around there, and then that way, it'll hold the light in. Now, I think I'll probably paint these black, just so that way it matches the top here. Now, something else that I wanted to point out to you. Even though I've got this piece of steel right here, you don't have to build these things like this. You don't have to go out and find some bed frame or some round tubular steel that'll fit this so you can put your lights inside of. What you also could do is, we know that this plastic tubing, I thought it was aluminum when we bought them, but it's plastic. I know that this plastic tubing fits right over that, the end. And this end has little ribs in it to help grip the plastic. What you could do is figure out, factor in how wide this is with the ribs, get a drill bit, build this all up, get a drill bit and drill straight down through that equals this size. Then you could stick this down through the hole, then cut off a section of this and stick it up through there to hold the light on. You know, you could probably use some super glue around it and hold it up. So you would cut off a little section of this, about an inch or whatever, to cover this up. So you could do it that way instead of using the piece of steel. Yeah. So let me paint these up and go on from there. Okay guys, there we go on this one. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm gonna get on out of here. I'd show you guys what these look like at nighttime, but we still got a lot of sunlight out here and I wanna get this video up and put out. I'm pretty sure you guys have a pretty good idea how these things are gonna work and what they're gonna look like. But anyways guys, I'm gonna get on out of here. I have to attend to this wound that I got when I was working on these things. And it's kind of a long, well, it's a dumb story and I don't wanna explain it. So I'm not gonna tell ya. Yeah, anyways, I'd like to welcome all my new subscribers and all my new viewers. I hope you guys like this build, and give it a thumbs up. Tell me what you think down in the comments section, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.